What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use Spongeforge in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Whether you are on your own server or if you've played on others, you might realize that most of the time owners are forced to choose between using plugins and mods, leaving something to be desired in the world. This is no longer an issue with Spongeforge, a type of mod compatible with Forge that allows you to actually install and use Spongeforge plugins with mods at the exact same time. While bucket-based plugins won't work, there are a ton of popular plugins that have been created specifically for Spongeforge. So with that, let's get started. Visit the Spongeforge download page and use the drop-down menu at the top to select the version that you're going to use. Click on the version and then you can use the download button to the right-hand side. You're going to want to save this new jar file to a safe location, like a separate folder, because we will use it again in just a minute. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and then scroll down to the game file section and make sure you're running a compatible Forge version that matches the version of the Spongeforge that you downloaded. After that, you can enter the FTP file access on the left-hand side, log in, and then find or create a mods folder, and then enter it. Press upload in the top left, and on the next page, drag and drop the Spongeforge jar file into upload. Once it has 100% uploaded, you can use the back button to return back to that mods folder. In most cases, you're going to want to rename that Spongeforge jar file so that it will load before any other mods on your server. From the mods folder, select your Spongeforge jar file and then press the rename button at the top of the page. And on the next page, you're going to want to add underscore capital A to the beginning of the file name. After this, press the submit button for the changes to take place, and then you can click on your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel where you can restart the server. Now that you have Spongeforge downloaded, you can head to the official Spongeforge plugin page and look for your desired plugins. Click the plugin to view its page and then check for any dependencies that it might have. And afterwards, head to the version tab to check for the download versions. Next to each download, you can check which version of Sponge is required. And when you're ready, click the version and then use the download button. Like before, you're going to want to save this jar file to a safe location on your computer. Head back to the Apex panel page and stop the server. And then enter the FTP file access and find and open that mods folder from before. Press upload again and then drag and drop any of your new Sponge plugins into the upload folder. Once they are 100% uploaded, use your server name again to return to the main panel. And then you're going to want to restart the server one more time to load in your new plugins. If your server is stuck loading and you've gone through and modified any of your mods, whether that be adding or deleting any of them, then your server may be waiting for a confirmation before fully loading the world. To do this, enter your server console and then type in FML confirm. If it's still loading, then you're most likely experiencing a crash. If that's what's happening and your server is crashing, then it might be due to having the wrong version of Sponge, a world issue, or mods with compatibility issues. Double check that you installed the correct version of Sponge to match your server. If you change your server version but kept the existing world, then this also may be the cause of the crash. To fix this, visit your panel page, press the Change World button, and then enter a new name. Once this has been done, make sure to restart your server and try again. If the server is crashing on startup after you add the plugins, then it's probably due to either a missing dependency, wrong version, or a corrupted jar file. Make sure you check the console to try and find exactly what the problem is. Check all of the plugins that you added and make sure they are all the correct version and that they don't have any dependencies that need to be downloaded as well. If you can confirm all of this and your panel still isn't starting, remove all of the plugins, and add them back in one by one to narrow down exactly which plugin might be the issue. If you're passionate about Minecraft, obviously you want your server to be enjoyable for everybody that might play. Whether that's adding mods, plugins, or both, you can have all of these options just by using Spongeforge. With so many options like world edit, grief prevention, and more, you'll honestly wonder how you ever ran a server without mods and plugins together. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.